100 million TikTok users here in the U.S. may have gotten a reprieve. President Trump has signed off on a deal letting Oracle and Walmart partner with TikTok's owner ByteDance to make TikTok a U.S.-based company. But moments ago, he cast new doubt, demanding that China give up complete control of the company. Our editor-in-chief, Andy Serwer, here with us now. Andy, this story is getting more confusing by the minute. I know you wrote a piece for our website over the weekend about this deal. You know, what is Trump, has Trump won here? Has he declared victory, do you think?
You see this? That's my head spinning, Alexis. I spent a lot of time over the past 72 hours wrapping my brain around this thing, and I thought I really nailed it, okay? Had it all figured out. But that was, you know, all changed just a few minutes ago. Now President Trump saying ByteDance, which is the parent, the Chinese parent company of TikTok, cannot be a shareholder, cannot be an owner of TikTok Global, which is the new U.S.-based company that he signed off on, which would be 20% owned by Oracle and Walmart combined, and another 20% owned by the venture capital firms General Atlantic and Sequoia, which were investors in ByteDance. Now the president is saying that other 60% cannot be owned by the Chinese company, but all of us are scratching their heads trying to figure out what the heck he means by that, because that was the deal he just signed off on. Now, it seems to be the case that what he's referring to is that an IPO of this business, which they had been talking about all along, which would occur next year, would somehow allow for an exit of the Chinese company. But that is so speculative. I mean, to get the Chinese to agree in principle on that, okay, fine, if there's an IPO and if it works out, yeah, I guess we would exit the company. I mean, it's very tough to understand how that would actually be something that anyone could guarantee. And I think what a lot of these parties are doing, including Oracle and Walmart, they're saying, there's a lot of Sturm und Drang going on here and craziness, but that's actually an advantage because we're the ones with the fortitude to go in here and buy this thing, whereas others might be scared because it's so crazy. But, you know, with these kinds of situations, there might be an opportunity here. And I think that's the thinking with Walmart and Oracle.
Andy, is it worth it for Oracle and Walmart to just get wade through this muck and mud of DC? Is the payback on the other side that much, is it sweet?
Absolutely. I mean, you look at it this way, in 60 days, it's possible this, you know, there's a clear path here that, you know, President Biden says, okay, fine, you guys own it. We're not gonna, you know, I'm signed off, it's good. I mean, that wouldn't be until January, but if he's elected. So there's that. Even if Trump wins, it's still a plum asset. Listen, I mean, TikTok in the United States is everything that Snap wanted to be, right? It is huge. It is the first real rival to Facebook, right? I mean, that's the way to look at this thing. 100 million people, wildly popular. Everyone's using it. And Oracle has this expertise to guarantee the security of the user's privacy. So to sort of carve that out from the Chinese, that's what Oracle does. They're very good at that. They worked with DoD for decades. So that's their expertise. Walmart is the consumer-facing partner here. Obviously, they get data, information about this incredibly huge, robust American population, particularly young people and teenagers love this platform. So I think it's, you know, arguably a great investment by these two companies.
All right, Andy, you know, a little later on, we're going to speak with a major content creator at TikTok, get her view on what's happening amidst all the drama. Andy Serwer, thank you.